We execute a call on the recursive factorial function. Assume that a method body contains the assignment z becomes fact of 3, and a frame for a call on this method is at the top of the call stack. We carry out the function call fact of 3. Here we go. First, push a frame for the call onto the call stack. Second, assign the values of the arguments of the call to the parameters. Well, the value of the argument is 3, so we store 3 in n. Third, execute the method body using the frame for the call to access parameters and local variables. N is 3, so execution of the if statement does nothing. Evaluating the return expression requires evaluating the function call fact of n minus 1. So we push a frame for the call onto the call stack. And now you can see why recursion works. Each call has its own space on the call stack for its parameters, local variables, and return address. It doesn't matter whether a call is recursive or not. It has its own space, and its method body is executed independently of all other calls. If you are still uneasy with executing recursive calls, we encourage you to execute the call, fact of 3, to completion yourself, following the algorithm for executing a method call slowly and carefully. The best way to learn and understand is to do.